Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, in today's video, we're gonna discuss the top 10 negative health consequences of a vegan diet. There are many negative health consequences of a vegan diet. However, today we're gonna limit ourselves to the most common issues. Let's get to it. Number one, the obvious digestive issues. No matter if it is stomach pain, bloating, farting, diarrhea, or it even goes so far that people have bloody stool. Yes, for many people, it still is not a wake-up call. Many vegans are caught up in their ideology and they are ignoring the negative health consequences of their vegan diet. They cannot listen to their own bodies, even if they're bleeding out of their own butts. Negative health consequence number two, the infamous brain fog. Yes, vegans know all too well what I'm talking about. It can be due to gluten intolerances. It can be due to malnutrition. It can be due to a sugar rush and a sugar drop. There are many, many reasons why vegans experience brain fog. Brain fog is huge in the vegan community. An inability to concentrate, an inability to speak, to focus. We see it in the vegan YouTube community especially. They cannot go through one video without 126 jump cuts. It is very, very sad. Side effect number three, tooth decay, dental issues, cavities, rotting teeth, even losing teeth. We've all seen it on the vegan diet. It is absolutely horrific. Yes, it is due to the sugars, but not only. People experience bad dental hygiene because of the lack in calcium, K2, and of course, vitamin D. All of those nutrients are missing in the vegan diet and they lead to dental decay. Side effect number four, depression. Depression that can be so severe that vegans experience suicidal thoughts. It is very, very sad. Those suicidal thoughts come in a package of misanthropy, a hate for their fellow men. Many vegans experience those symptoms due to malnutrition. Their brains are deprived of very important nutrients and hence they develop this hate towards everyone. It is essentially this hate and disgust for people that are truly happy. Of course, out of that dogmatic belief system, vegans like to blame the others, as dirty flesh eaters, murderers, rapists, and whatnot. And they like to tell themselves that that is why they are depressed. They're depressed because the animals are suffering. It couldn't be further from the truth. The vegans are suffering because they are malnourished. Side effect number five, not as severe as the other side effects and therefore often ignored. It is the constant hunger, an inability to feel satisfied, never being satisfied. This is why we see so many vegans eating tons and tons of food. When you see a vegan mukbang, they eat a whole table worth of food. You could feed a whole family with it, if it would be animal food, that is. Nevertheless, they try to stuff themselves. They try to put in more just to feel their guts expand, just to feel some sort of satiation. But true satiation can only be felt when you nourish your body. And that is what the vegans are lacking. Their vegan diet is so deficient in all the crucial vitamins, minerals, and other nutrients. It is lacking, and this is why your body will never feel satisfied. Your body is not craving more sugars. Your body is not craving more fiber. Your body is craving nutrients that you cannot get. Do I have to name the obvious ones? B12, DHA, EPA, vitamin A. Do you really need more? There's so many vitamins, minerals, and nutrients lacking on the vegan diet, and your body will constantly call you out. You will experience hunger during eating. You will be gulping down on your smoothie and you will still be hungry. It is absolutely sad. Downside number 6, unfavorable body composition, aka the inability to build muscle. We all know the vegan skinny fat look. That is because vegans predominantly consume energy. Energy in forms of sugars. The body requires building materials. Building materials predominantly are proteins, high quality absorbable proteins from animal flesh. Vegans do not eat them. They concentrate on energy, on sugars, carbohydrates. But your body only needs so much. Don't buy into the dogma, people. Don't believe, but the preferred fuel source is glucose. Yes, it is, but you need only so much. You don't need 1 kilogram of carbohydrates every single day. Why would you? Do you run a marathon every single day? You need building blocks, building materials that regenerate the body, that build your body. You don't have to be a bodybuilder for this. It is about skin repair, hair repair, nails, so on and so forth, your organs. Everything needs protein. And this is why you see the muscular atrophy in vegans, an absolute skinny fat look. They're fueling their adipose tissues, their fatty tissues, and they're not fueling their muscles. But you have to take into account that the muscles are only an external display of health. You are storing the proteins in your lean muscle mass. But you have to think about what is happening to the vegan's organs. Those organs need protein for regeneration. If you do not give your body protein, you will experience decay in all of your bodily tissues. It is an absolute horrific way to deprive your body of much needed nutrients. And this is why you see vegans constantly failing in the gym. And do not give me the vegan steroid bodybuilders. Negative health outcome number 7, heart problems. Yes, how can that be?
The vegan diet is the only one that reverses heart disease.
Yeah. In a short-term intervention. Follow up those vegan studies and you will see that nobody stayed on that vegan diet. As a short-term cleanse, as a fast, it might be not a bad idea. But a water fast shortly is not a bad idea either. However, if you prolong your vegan diet, you can run into heart problems. We all know that vegetable oils can lead to heart problems, to heart failure. But aside from that, many vegans report arrhythmia and low or high blood pressure. Sodium, potassium, mineral imbalances can manifest in heart problems. And this is what many vegans experience, despite the vegan dogma. Negative health outcome number 8. Anxiety and social disorders. Yes, you could say that is pretty much depression, but not always. Not every vegan is depressed, of course. Anxiety, however, is much more common. A general feeling of unease, a general feeling of irritation. You feel socially paranoid. Many vegans experience that. And I know, again, the excuse will be that is only because everybody eats meat. No. This can be due to your gut lining triggering diet that will constantly provoke your gut and will lead to anxiety, social paranoia. It is very common. It's not only the gut triggering foods. It is a lack in B12 and B6 and the other B vitamins that you cannot find readily available in plant foods. If you combine gut triggering foods with the lack of vitamins, you are in for a disaster. This is why the vegans are anxious and socially paranoid. Side effect number 9, bad sleep. Yes, either too deep or not deep enough. Many vegans report on bathroom visits. They have to wake up every night to pee 6-7 times sometimes. It is absolutely draining for your human physiology. A constant state of dehydration. Many vegans can't even drink enough. They feel that they have to gulp down on smoothie bowls, water in between to hydrate themselves. The reason why they are dehydrated is that they are lacking the animal fats, which are so hydrating. All of that leads to bad sleep. If you combine all the side effects that we already listed here, they all will lead to bad sleep. Indigested, insoluble fiber in your colon, rotting, provoking you, and you won't find rest. Many people report on bad sleep in combination with a restlessness, an absolute waking dead state. Alright guys, and the last negative health outcome of a vegan diet would be injuries. Injuries, you might say, everybody has injuries. Yes, the difference is injuries and the inability to heal. When an athlete acquires an injury, most of the time you see them jump back. Rampage Jackson in the UFC. Two new kneecaps made out of plastic. No worries, back into the octagon, still fighting. You see regular athletes jump back. Regular athletes, meat eaters, they recover. Vegans, not so much. You see vegans and their careers. Once an injury is acquired, and that happens quickly to vegans, they cannot reclaim their health. They cannot snap back to their initial health. Once they are down, they won't get up. Once they're injured, their careers are over. Alright guys, and this video is over as well. I hope you like the list. Guys, take into consideration, you as a vegan, if you watch this video, you might not have all of those side effects. I get it. Not everybody gets full-blown end-stage veganism. Understood. But even if you have one, two, or three of those side effects, it is time for you to change your diet. Alright guys, but this is it for today's video. If you like this video, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so. And guys, if you want to support the channel through our Patreon, for example, you can join our Patreon list for as little as $1. It is greatly appreciated. And guys, if you have no money to spend, understood as well, of course, you can save our Amazon link. Just go through our portal and you can buy whatever you want to buy. It doesn't cost you anything extra, but the channel gets a small commission, a small cut. And this is a great way to support the cause. Alright guys, this is it. As always, much love and peace.